गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम यू बैक अगेन टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल। आई एम योर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर टीचर ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 एंड ऑलरेडी चैप्टर 3 हैज बीन स्टार्टेड, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर। सो द चैप्टर इज अबाउट होम सिकनेस। अ बॉय, ही वॉन्टेड टू फील होम सिकनेस, ही वॉन्टेड टू कम बैक टू हिज होम। फॉर दिस ही वॉन्टेड टू डू समथिंग, ही हैड अ प्लान। He thought of making himself sick and how? By just showing that he is suffering from appendicitis. Why he chosen this? Because he knew what are the symptoms of it, because a few months ago only his sister undergone the operation of appendicitis. So he knows all the symptoms of this disease. Now what happens? As I went upstairs and knocked on the brown door after breakfast, I did not even feel frightened of the matron. Now, matron means a woman who is in charge of the living and medical arrangements of the children at a boarding school. That means she overlooks or she takes care of the children who stays in the boarding. So now, till here, whatever things we came to know, that is about the boy who he started recalling all these things, that how he will make himself feel that he is suffering from appendicitis. So he went to the matron's room one day, and then what happens? Come in, booms the voice. So then he asked to enter the room. I entered the room clutching my stomach on the right hand side and staggering pathetically. Staggering means walking with very difficulty. These are all the whatever he is doing, these are all a kind of acting. Okay, so whatever now he will do, these are all his acting. Why? Because he wanted to come back to his home. So the matron, when he entered the matron's room, he was walking with very difficulty, and then he clutched his stomach on the right hand side. What's the matter with you? The matron shouted. So matron, she shouted on that boy and she asked. It hurts, matron, I moaned. Oh, it hurts so much, just here. So he had to show how much pain he is having in his stomach. So because of that only he said in this way. You have been overeating, she snapped. What do you expect of your gobble cake all day long? So what matron said that maybe you must have eaten a lot, that is why your stomach is paining. I haven't eaten a thing for days, I lied. I couldn't eat, matron, I simply couldn't. So what he said that I couldn't eat because of my stomach pain. Get on the bed, she ordered. So there was a bed, so she said to sleep on the bed. I lay on the bed and she began prodding my tummy with her fingers. Prodding means looking or pushing with a pointed object. I was watching her carefully, and when she hit what I guessed was the appendix place, so he had to show that he is suffering from appendix. This is what he wanted to show. So when the matron, he started looking or pushing into the stomach of the boy, he was just watching carefully, and when the place came where the appendix used to be, at that time he started shouting. I let out a cry that rattled the window panes. Oh, I cried out. Don't, matron. So he said that, matron, you please don't hit in that part. Don't. Then I slipped in the clincher. I've been sick all morning, I moaned, and now there's nothing left to be sick with, but I still feel sick. So actually he wanted to show matron that he is having he is suffering from appendicitis, and that was why when the matron hits that place he shouted. This was the right move. I saw her hesitate. So he can see that matron is also a little bit worried about that. Stay where you are, she said, and walked quickly from the room. Then she said to the boy that you please stay here, I'm coming. She had had a nurse's training and she did not want a ruptured appendix on her hands. Ruptured means broken or burst, okay? So she did at nursing also, so she knows nicely what are the symptoms. So when he shouted, when the nurse touched at the place where appendix used to be, so the nurse, I think she guessed that the boy is suffering from appendicitis. Within an hour, the doctor arrived and he went through the same prodding and poking, and I did my yelping at what I thought were the proper times. Then he put a thermometer in my mouth. So the nurse, matron, she walked out because she called the doctor. She went to call the doctor. When the doctor came, the same thing happened. Again, he just shouted at the same place where the appendix used to be. And then then the doctor put a thermometer in the mouth of the boy. Now what happens, whether the boy was able to go back to his home or he has to stay in the hostel itself, that I will reveal in my next video. Till then, you read chapter 3. Thank you.